And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Eotriceratops, which was a request from Noctum Von Doom via our Patreon and Discord. So thanks. Eotriceratops was a Chasmosaurine ceratopsian that lived in the Late Cretaceous in what is now Alberta, Canada. It was found on dry island in the Horseshoe Canyon Formation. And it looks a lot like Triceratops. It's got the two big brow horns and a small nasal horn and a frill and a beak. It's one of the largest ceratopsians. So other large ceratopsians include Triceratops, horridus, and the ichnogenus Ceratopsipes, which is based on that name, Trax. Eotriceratops is estimated to be 29.5 feet or 9 meters long, although Gregory Paul estimated it to be 27.8 feet or 8.5 meters long and weigh 10 tons. The holotype skull is estimated to be 9.8 feet or 3 meters long.
Ooh, that's a big skull.
Yeah. So, yeah, like I said, one of the largest ceratopsians. It was an herbivore. It had this relatively flat, long snout. The rostral is large, and from the side looks somewhat boomerang-shaped. An Eoraptor had 35 tooth rows preserved in the maxilla. And it had unique features in the premaxilla, nasal horn core, squamosal frill, and epijugal. So it had these long crescent or spindle-shaped epoccipitals on the squamosal frill, so these bones lining the bottom of the frill. It had this sharply conical epijugal on the cheek. And had a low nasal horn that was slightly recurved, and this nasal horn core was longer than it was wide. The horns above its eyes curved forward, and those were about 2.6 feet or 80 centimeters long.
Yeah, it sounds a lot like Triceratops, except for maybe the epoccipitals, because I think Triceratops didn't have a whole lot of frill ornamentation.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the other interesting thing was there were three bite marks found above the eye near the base of the left horn, and they think that could have been from scavengers. The type and only species is Eotriceratops ixerensolaris, and the genus name Eotriceratops means dawn three-horned face.
So I'm guessing that means that it was an ancestor or in an older formation than Triceratops?
Yes, so it's a close relative of Triceratops, Nettoceratops, and Torosaurus, or, depending on who you ask, all Triceratops. And when it was named, it was found to be the oldest known member of this group. So that's why the Dawn three-horned face.
Does anybody consider Eotriceratops to be also Triceratops?
Yes, in 2010, Gregory Paul renamed Eotriceratops to Triceratops, but most people didn't agree with that.
Okay.
The species name means of the dry island and refers to Dry Island Buffalo Jump Provincial Park, where the specimen was found. So the fossils of Eotriceratops were actually found in 1910 by Barnum Brown during an American Museum of Natural History expedition. But Brown at the time was more interested in the Albertosaurus skeletons that were in the same location, so he didn't do anything with that find.
But he collected it?
No. What happened was in 2001, a team from the Royal Tyrol and Canadian Museum of Nature went on an expedition to Dry Island, and they didn't know that Barnum Brown had already found this specimen.
91 years earlier?
Yeah, but Glenn Guthrie, the camp cook of the team, rediscovered the skeleton by accident.
Wow. And it was still in decent shape after 91 Canadian winters.
Mm-hmm. Maybe not too much was showing.
Yeah. Or maybe it wasn't in as good of shape, but we don't know how good of shape it originally was in.
So Eotriceratops was described and named in 2007 by Xiaochun Wu and others, and it's the first identifiable dinosaur found in the upper 65 feet or 20 meters of the Horseshoe Canyon Formation. And it was found in carbonaceous shale. There's no duplicate bones that have been found, so it's been interpreted to all belong to one specimen, the holotype. And the holotype is a partial skeleton with a skull, no lower jaws. It includes the neck and back vertebrae, ribs, and ossified tendons, and the skull includes parts of the frill sides, the large horns above the eyes, and the horn above the nose.
Yeah, it's pretty good for a ceratopsian. That gives you a lot of information.
Yeah. The left premaxilla was more complete than the right, and the bones, especially the skull, were disarticulated, and some of them were badly crushed. The brain case was badly crushed. More potential Eotriceratops specimens have been found in New Mexico, but they've been classified as Ohoceratops fowleri, and Torosaurus utahensis.
For now.
Yes. For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.